simple thing. Because here I have quite a number of Myanmarese staff. So when the cycle happened, I called a meeting of all the Myanmarese boys and girls, and I, you know, at first I wanted to collect money so that they can send it back to their families. But fortunately, touch wood, none of my staff here or their families were affected by the cyclone at all. Thank God. So when that happened, we had this idea of doing something to collect money for the Myanmarese victims of the cyclone. And then the China earthquake happened. So I said, okay, we should do something and collect some money for, you know, in our little way, to help the victims in Myanmar and China. That was how the idea came about. And originally, when the idea was mooted, of course, a lot of the partners were saying, you know, we should publicize it on the, in the newspapers and blah, blah, blah. And at first I agreed, but then when I thought about it, I said, no, we shouldn't do that. Because if we publicize the event on the newspapers or on the radio, it would appear that we are actually capitalizing on other people's misfortune, which is not the whole idea at all. So I refused to publicize it in the newspapers. I said, if you want to do this, let's do it sincerely. We'll call our friends to come. And whatever money we make for the night, every single cent we'll donate to the funds for Myanmar and China. Not very much, really. I mean, compared to funds that have half a million ringgit or whatever, ours would be very, very small. I think by the end of the night, we should be able to raise about 10 15,000 ringgit in total. And a lot of this would have come from generous Malaysians who heard about this from my phone calls and SMSs, and who could not attend the function tonight, but who were generous enough to say, Patrick, I won't be able to attend the dinner, but here is a check for 5,000. You just put it into the fund and donate it. Yeah.
Right, it was good.
Well, that's a bonus.
Thank you.
Thank you.